Hi, my name is Mark Richard, and I'm the president and CEO of the Downtown Spokane Partnership. Well, you know, I've thought long and hard about this. I think there are really, in my mind, probably it's a complicated issue, no doubt, but I try to boil it down to a handful of items, and one of those I feel very confident in working with our nonprofits are that we need more either access, I would just say access to mental health and substance abuse treatment. I don't know, I'm not engaged enough to understand whether we need more money, but we certainly need more slots. We need more access. I think equally what we hear is that we need better access to affordable housing. So we need not only access to subsidized housing, but also making sure that new entry homes can be built affordably. So how do we incentivize and provide a permit process so that a brand new starter home isn't too expensive? So access to housing, right? We also have a plethora, as you know, of old housing stock that is just around in our commuting, sitting vacant, has been abandoned, and those need to be, I think, refurbished and made accessible. So those are a few things. We need increased access to the trades and the trade schools and, frankly, employment. So one way to get access to housing is to increase people's ability to generate an income for people that are capable. And in my mind, I know from an industry standpoint, we have a shortage of folks going into the trades, excellent paying jobs, doesn't require a four-year degree, and yet I don't see that pipeline being filled. And then finally, I would just say it's incredibly important, once we're focusing on all the things, we also need to make sure that the housing facilities that we have the proper staffing, and the service providers. So it's very important to build low barrier housing. We're a supporter of low barrier housing and that notion of getting a person off the street and then starting to work on their challenges. But if we don't have the proper level of case management in those facilities, that person is not getting the help they need when they need it. So just having a staff person sitting at the counter between 8 and 5 in the afternoon is not when a person that's suffering from mental illness or an addiction needs that help. So how do we make sure that we're providing the proper staffing? And then finally, I would say really an important element, and that is we need to make sure that we are providing hope and dignity through accountability and intervention when necessary. And so you're going to read, you have read a lot about our work on just one element of many that we work on, and that is the sit and lie ordinance. You know, and our partnership with the community court and our partnership with all of these agencies, many of which here support the sit and lie ordinance. And the reason is because these agencies here today, many of them will offer services, they'll offer housing, they'll offer assistance, and hundreds of people will refuse that help. Hundreds of people are not here today because they're not interested in help. People that are suffering from mental illness, suffering from addiction, that either don't know they need help or they're not ready for help. We as a community need to love them in a stronger way, in a more impactful way than saying, here's a sandwich, I'm going to love you on the street and I'm going to, you know, empower you to be on the street, as opposed to saying, please come with me, and if you're not ready, we're going to kind of encourage you to be ready, and we're going to work you through the system. We're going to get you the help you need. And so I think we desperately need that accountability piece. What we see in other communities like Seattle, where housing homelessness is out of control, is in part there's not that on the back end. There's nothing to say, when you refuse all of our love and help as a community, what can we do then? We need a way to move you off the street with these tools. And then related to that is, I think at the national level, we need to really look at our policies and make sure that we have a policy that doesn't disincentivize incredible states and cities like ours who are trying to do the right thing. We have neighboring states around us, I'm not going to name them today, but that are woefully inadequate in the amount of services they provide. Why should their strategy on how they care for their people that are vulnerable be to send them to Washington State or send them to Spokane? That disincentivizes these communities from doing the right thing, and of course it overburdens our agencies such that we can't care for our own. And so I really think at the national level we need to look at a policy that says, you know, if you're not willing to take our federal money and to provide adequate services for the people that are from your state, we need to figure out a means to get you there, because instead what's happening is folks are migrating to wonderful states and cities like ours who are willing to do the right thing, and frankly we can't carry that burden alone. Oh, it's amazing. I think you know, we just look around. I've been here a couple of years during this program, and I think the ability for a person to be able to come in and to be able to walk through a path and a journey to say, you know, my issues are complicated. They're none of them are the same, right? They're like everybody's, you know, individuality is like a snowflake. So we have, you know, dozens of service providers that are here custom making a plan for each human being that comes through these doors. Their opportunity and chances of success have just skyrocketed because you've got all these people here together, working together. I mean, right? And so that's one other challenge is I might go to this agency, I've got to go clear across town, I've got to get help here, and then I got to understand that agency even exists, and then I got to get there. Instead, they can one bus ticket and they're here and they can navigate through this system, and these service providers can provide a plan for that person as opposed to a piecemeal approach. So I think it's absolutely beautiful, and just seeing the folks here that are receiving help is warming, isn't it? I mean, it's just warming to your heart. Yeah.